Very good evening, friends. Myself, Dr. Sahej Joshi, and today I'm going to discuss about Watts and its homeopathic medicines. So let's start. Watts are rough hard growth on the skin caused by infection with HPV. HPV is nothing but human papilloma virus. Each strain of HPV is responsible for infecting specific body areas. A person can get wart by skin-to-skin contact with a person having warts. Warts can also arise by coming in contact with an object that is infected with human papilloma virus. A weak immune system raises the risk of contracting the infection, leading to a condition known as wart. Among various types of warts, the major ones are flat warts, filiform warts, and common warts. Flat warts have smooth surface, arising mainly on face, neck, hand and knees, while filiform warts are thread-like warts arising near the eyelids or lips. Common warts are rough, raised skin, colored wart that arises on hand. Common warts are also known as verruca vulgaris. The wart that arise on feet are known as plantar warts. Under conventional mode of treatment, generally cauterization is adopted. It is a technique of burning a part of a body to remove or close off a part of it. Second, they adopt is cryosurgery, in which they use liquid nitrogen to freeze that particular object. While homeopathic remedies for warts treat this condition in a very safe, mild, gentle and painless way, homeopathic medicines follows a curative approach to treat warts rather than suppressing them. Homeopathic medicine boosts the immune system of the body to fight with the infectious agent that is causing the warts. Homeopathic medicines are prepared from naturally occurring substance, hence they are free from any side effects. The best homeopathic medicines for warts are very effective, deep acting, and gives highly promising results. Generally, I use following homeopathic medicines for treating warts. The first and the most important remedy in my list is Thuja occidentalis. Thuja occidentalis is an excellent remedy for warts that are seedy, large or pedunculated. Skin dryness may also be there with warts, and skin is very sensitive to touch. Warts in anogenital area can easily be cured by using Thuja occidentalis. The second best remedy which I use in my clinical practices is causticum. Causticum is generally indicated for warts and skin tag, for large and jagged warts. Warts that arise generally on face, lips, nose and eyelids. Wonders in treating cases of warts which are on the tips of finger tips. Warts that are painful. And it is also helpful in treating various cases of pedunculated warts. The third medicine which I use in my practice is nitric acid. And nitric acid is for warts that bleed easily. Bleeding from warts arise from touching or washing is indicated symptom of nitric acid. It is warts in this case are very sensitive to touch. And they have a tendency of stinging or stitching pains in the particular area having warts. The fourth and foremost remedy which I use in my clinical practice, and it is the best medicine, I generally use this medicine along with Thuja, that is Antimcrude. Antimcrude is a very, very, very excellent remedy for horny warts on soles. It works well on corns and warts as well as they arise together. Antimcrude is very excellent remedy for treating cases of warts along with Thuja. Thuja occidentalis and Antimcrude are very much specific remedy for treating the cases of warts. Hope so, friends, you liked my video. Hope so, there you must be sharing this video and using these remedies. You can even contact me if you are having any trouble, if any one of you are suffering from warts. They can easily contact me on my mobile number, and I can surely help you in this case to get rid from this condition. Thank you so much, Dr. Sahid Joshi Desai.